EGIN is a European group of global networks of accounting firms and associations as well. And it brings together all the major accounting firms outside the Big Four. The main objective of EGIN is to create a platform for its members and to speak as one voice with outside stakeholders. And I have the privilege to be the chair of that organization. EGIN members welcome the package as it is laid down in the regulation and in the directive. They believe that the European citizens, over 500 million, they deserve an open and vibrant audit market, especially for the public interest, in the public interest, and especially also for listed companies. So we think it is a balanced and good package. It's important to realize, of course, that this whole process is a political process that took over 4 to 5, almost 4 years. And of course, as inevitably, you have a watering down effect. So the final rules are not as radical as the earlier ones in 2010. But I think that the political objectives that were stated at the very start have been met. And I think in 4 to 5 years, we will remember 2013 as a historic year for the audit profession, because fundamental changes will have taken place as a result. And I think we need those changes, really, in our profession. And of course, you can always argue about details, whether they are effective or not. But as I said, the overall package is a very reasonable one. I think some parts of the new rules will bring about a real significant change in the relationship between the auditor or the auditor's firm and its clients and other stakeholders. In particular, I'm referring to things like the auditor's communication, the new rules on that, the enhancement of the audit committee role, the third, the provision of non-audit services, the obligatory tendering in a transparent manner, and of course, last but not least, the audit firm rotation. These are really fundamental changes, and I think that people will see that these changes really make a difference in the relationship. People start realizing that auditors are not there forever. There comes a time that they need to rotate off. And secondly, auditors cannot do everything. There is a limit of what they can do in combination with their audit work. And I'd like to mention the third point, and that is the joint audit. The joint audit is introduced in the new rules as an extension of the rotation period. And I think that's an important element as well. Well, EGIN members believe that the concept of joint audit fits perfectly with the original political objectives that were stated at the very start. Without going in details, joint audit contributes to the audit quality, the work of the auditor, and also enhances its independence. And there's a third element, and that is, it is the only proven measure to have a good impact on the high level of concentration in the audit market. And we all know that this high level of concentration is a concern to politicians. In some sectors, in some countries, there is simply a lack of choice. And we need to do something about it. And one of the things, and joint audit is one of those things, and maybe actually the only one. And we think that the introduction of joint audit will bring about more additional players in the market. And that is what we need, because more additional players will mean innovation. And innovation is really what this market needs.